Hello everyone and welcome to the first episode of MC CRIBS, the first episode of many to show off our various different houses we've built on the many plots on our servers. This week we're starting off with the PS3 Minecraft City, showing off buildings like the Myth Ninja Emergency Response Building, where he has everything prepared for disaster, as he has fireman suits, police station equipment, as well as a beautiful view of the city from above to prevent it from disaster. And Pounhandler's very first Pounhandler's Cafe, the first of many, where he gives us a grand tour of the first social gathering spot on the PS3, as well as offering us a delicious cookie. First, I'd like to start off by saying thank you for tuning in and welcome to our channel. This is our MC Cribs first episode, where again we're showing off the various different homes that have been built. This one featuring the PS3 Minecraft City, because if you watch their very first video on the channel, it was a server tour of our PS3 city, and we didn't get a chance to actually show off many of the homes, so this gives us an opportunity for those that want to show their houses in our world to send us a video or send us a picture or even send us a message to AngelKing47000, and we'll be more than happy to check out your place. Now, for the meantime, we're checking out my redstone mansion to start things off and set the tone for what's to come. Here's my first entrance here, where I open it up and I'm welcomed by a palm tree and waterfall columns. And I like that glass ceiling because it actually gives off a nice view of the sky, as you can see the sun setting down there. We also got a nice living room quarters over this way, separated by the water columns. And I like to play my music in here and get my dance on. Helps me think. Pull out my favorite CD by the dispenser here and flop on some tunes. I know you can't hear right now, but in my mind, in my Minecraft, there's music playing and I'm dancing to it. It's like boom, chicka, boom, chicka, boom, chicka, boom. And then when we end up taking a walk over here, in case it gets a little bit dark and gloomy, you want to set the tone to a different spot, you can turn on the redstone lamps there, flick the switch here, and you can throw a log or a body in the fire and close down the couch there so it extends the dance floor. Flicking that switch will get in some natural light from the window shutters, which I thought was a nice touch. And then I'll close that up. We're not throwing anything in there right now. And then, walking down over this way, we'll take a look at my kitchen with my beautiful black and white checkered floor. I thought right away, that makes it look like a kitchen. And unpractical, though, because I wouldn't want white carpet in the kitchen. But anywho, if you wanted to cook some pork chops or some chicken, oh, look, we're going to cook some chicken, and I already got a cooked pork chop. Right on, this kitchen's working. And then if you walk this way, you can see my little crafting table pops up out of the ground. I always thought that was cool how it did that. And then flicking this switch will also activate the other window shutters. And you can sit down here and take a break while your food's cooking and have a piece of cake. Come by and say, hey, Angel, it's my birthday today. And I'll be like, come on over. We'll have some cake. And why not? And then walking over here talking about pool parties or birthday parties, any kind of party, you can always have a pool in it. Light it up too at night or during the day if you want to get crazy. And watch the sun set as you take a nice dive off the diving board. I mean, I'm just going to walk up here and you can't really jump because you might hit your head a little bit. You can run off and go woo right into the pool. I don't know, kind of dunk in for a swim before bed. And then walking up this way, you'll be able to see how the lights go off here in the pool. But instead of taking the stairs, let's take the elevator. Don't have a redstone elevator, but I do have a cool glass door that shows off another cool view of the sunset there, and a water elevator. That's how I made a lot of my water elevators were made when I was first starting off playing Minecraft. And I don't know, kind of a nice feel to it. Like, I'm refreshed when I come off the elevator. So it works out. There's a win there. And then up here is my bedroom. I can take the stairs down there, or I can test out the bed. And I like to say this is where the magic happens, but it doesn't, because it's Minecraft. But I can sleep in it, and to demonstrate how comfortable my bed is, I'm going to take a nice, long nap, and wake up, hopefully, in the morning. Oh, okay, so another day has passed here in Minecraft, and the sun is now where the moon used to be. And I'm just waking up here in my bedroom, on the first house to be shown on the MC Cribs. Thank you all again for coming in and watching this. And we are now going to end this first tour of the first home by closing the doors and heading on over to the other side of the world on this Minecraft PS3 city, and heading to Moderator Myth Ninja and his emergency response building. Alright, it is now nighttime. It took me a full day to travel from one side of the city to the other, but I finally made it here, and we are in the most safest spot in the whole server, the emergency response building, brought to us by Myth Ninja. He has graciously decided to give us a tour of the facilities, but it is very strict inside, and the rules are quite clear and are disciplined if you decide not to follow the rules. So it's very strict, and he gave me a specific time to be here. So I'm going to arrive exactly when he told me to, and I'm going to hopefully he'll greet me at the doors here. Oh, hey, Myth Ninja, how's it going?
Hey, AngelKing buddy, how you doing, man? How about you come inside my house and check it out?
Well, thank you for having us over.
Hey, man, it's nice to have you here. So this is the fire department / police station.
Okay.
So you haven't been here yet. Let me give you a quick little tour. So right over here is our standard police uniform that all our police officers wear. It's just standard leather armor.
I see.
And then right across the room, we have our SWAT team armor.
Oh, wouldn't want to mess with those guys.
You haven't seen it already? And then right across the way, we have the fire department uniform.
Okay.
For just in case any emergencies.
I see.
They have some axes and golden armor. And then right across here, we have our riot armor, just in case people decide to try to destroy the city. We're ready for it. And then we also have our field combat medics with all of our more expensive weaponry.
Well, it looks like you guys are prepared for pretty much anything. You ever had to respond to something?
Yeah, man. And then there was actually an incident where a house caught fire, and we actually went and go take control of it with the water buckets we have right in front of that chest over there. Nice. So it's definitely something interesting. You never know what can happen in Minecraft, you know?
That's for sure.
So how about you follow me upstairs?
Okay, sounds good. You lead the way.
I'm going to go right up here past the SWAT armor.
Okay.
And right up here in the second floor, we have our barracks and our enchantment room.
Okay.
Where all of our police and fire department stays and sleeps if they need to.
Lots of beds.
Then right upstairs in the third floor, it's the watch. Or as I like to call the watch.
The watch.
This is where we can send emergency signals to other players if we want to.
Whoa.
And we also have a defense system on all four sides, and all of these control that. But unfortunately, it does kind of pepper the next door neighbor's house.
I can see that. And, there's a fire.
We do understand that these houses here are on fire. We have put it out many times, but the owner insists on relighting them and says that they're supposed to be there, so we leave them. But it does kind of get on our nerves a little bit. But other than that, that's been my crib. And I hope you guys enjoyed.
We definitely did.
And now get out of my house.
Oh! Okay, we're leaving. As you can tell, they're very strict here, but for a good reason.
Myth Ninja's gonna make sure we walk out of here. We've seen too much. We're being escorted out of the premises. But thank you again, Myth Ninja, for showing us your home and your emergency response building. Oh, he's seeing us out by shutting the doors. And thank you once again, Myth Ninja. That was great. Now we're going to Pounhandler's, first Pounhandler's Cafe. And here we are, not too far away from Myth Ninja's emergency response building, a couple of blocks down the road from the Minecraft City PS3. We're here at Pounhandler's very first Pounhandler's Cafe, where many could socialize and get together. Pounhandler's Cafes have been served through lots of the PS3 and PS4 Minecraft worlds as a social gathering. So, and there he is right there.
Welcome, traveler. Welcome to my fine eating establishment.
Well, thank you for having us.
You can either have a seat wherever you choose, or you can come to the counter and I'll serve you myself.
Well, it's been too long since I've last been here. Think I'll have myself a cookie, good sir.
There you go, sir.
Why, thank you.
It's on the house.
Awesome.
How would you like to see our kitchens?
I would love to. Lead the way.
Got a very large kitchen / storage area that you can enjoy. Well, that our cooks enjoy. also have a variety of food stored here. We'll never run out. Never run out of food. So there's always good things to eat.
Well, that's good to know.
Follow me. We'll head to the second floor.
Very spacious. Let's see this second floor. Pounhandler again, one of the moderators on our PS3 and PS4 Minecraft worlds, has actually done a great service by providing Pounhandler cafes throughout many of our Minecraft cities.
Our second floor terrace provides ample views to our north and south. And if you come to the balcony, you have a beautiful view of the central city and the spawn point. So you can watch travelers come and go as you eat your meals. Truly glorious.
Glorious indeed, good sir. This is awesome, Pounhandler.
If you follow me to the third floor, I'll show you my private room.
All right. Let's check it out. Wow.
Very open concept. Great views.
I see that.
To the same areas as the balcony. So I may see who comes and goes.
Wicked.
This is my fine eating establishment.
Fantastic, Pounhandler.
It's my first, but it's not my last.
Definitely not. Well, thank you again, Pounhandler, for showing us your first Pounhandler's Cafe here in the PS3 Minecraft City. It was definitely a pleasure. Thank you so much for showing us this great house and this great build on your plot. And that ends the first episode of MC Cribs. Hopefully more to come. And if you guys want to show your house, feel free to send me a video or send me a picture or send me a message at AngelKing47000. And make sure to stay tuned to the very end of this video to get a sneak peek of our Build Wars PS4 edition, which we'll be having our first event this weekend, July 12th.
Have a good day, sir. Enjoy your travels in Minecraft.
Thank you too, Pounhandler, for that great tour, and thank you all for watching.